1360 WSAI, it's the revolution of talk radio, it's yoga, the other 98%. Awful glad that you're here. If you're listening for the very, very first time, we do the show every week at 7 o'clock. If you're an advanced yoga practices a fan, I apologize if you got the information that it wasn't going to be at this time, and hopefully we can make that up to you and have Yogani on again. In order to do that, we're going to need your help. This is all funded by a nonprofit organization, part of the Cincinnati Yoga School. It's Virtues First.
Yes, Virtues First is involved with bringing you this show and other great speakers as well. And it mentioned earlier that we have a school that we started in India for children that normally wouldn't get any education. If you'd like to give a donation to us, the address is 11130 Kenwood Road, Cincinnati, Ohio, 45242. And that's also the address for the Cincinnati Yoga School. Virtues First is what we would call the yogic arm, or the karma yoga arm, the selfless service arm of the yoga school. So do we have a caller?
Yeah, we appreciate your help, so any way that you can. Yogani, you still there?
I'm still here.
Good to have you. How about let's go to California. California and Nier. Nier, you're on with Yogani.
Hi, Yogani. This is Nier.
Thanks
a lot for all the... I'm fine. How are you? Thanks a lot for all the lessons on the website. I have a question. My question is specifically regarding, I see a lot of people who do yoga practices for a lot of years, but they don't see any results, or they might end up giving up at some point. Is it that yoga results are only for specific people, or only for people who are destined to reach that goal, or is it open for everybody? Is it like anybody can get a result?
I think everybody can do it, Nir. Everybody has their own, what I call, matrix of, I hate to use the word obstructions, but, you know, we're all kind of wired through our nervous system and have various restrictions, you know, whether they're psychological or on a subtle physical level. And we have to get underneath those, which we do with deep meditation and spinal breathing and other techniques, and we gradually release them from within. Now, sometimes you can meditate on what I call a plateau. You know, you learn to meditate and things are great for a couple of months, and then nothing seems to be happening for a couple of months. Well, what's happening is this various stresses and strains and obstructions in our nervous system to the silence that's within us are gradually being dissolved from underneath. And then, you know, one day you come out of your sitting practices and, whoa, you know, everything looks different. So it's sort of can be a little bit of a cat and mouse game like that. So, but we're all the same as far as our capabilities are concerned. Our nervous mm-hmm. systems are all a doorway to the divine, and it's just a matter of going through the purification process. And we need to do that obviously in an orderly way and a safe way. But that's what needs to be done. Do I have a minute, Scott, to just go back to the crown practices for a minute?
Yeah, it's 7:55:30 right now, so we got a couple of minutes. I'll let you know when we got to wrap
up. Okay, and this is really related because we bring in other practices to accelerate progress once we have deep meditation going. And the first one after that is spinal breathing, and that is a breathing technique that, as it sounds, traces the spine from the root of our body at the perineum up to the brow, the center brow. And this is a balanced practice that cultivates the nervous system to be a better conductor, if you will, of the inner silence that we're bringing up in meditation. And the reason I mentioned the crown practices is spinal breathing is the way that we avoid the difficulties of a premature kundalini awakening. Spinal breathing is a very powerful practice, but it's also a very balancing practice. So it takes us forward in terms of awakening our ecstatic energies inside, and it also serves as a buffer to avoid the kind of problems that can happen with crown practices. So I did want to throw that in. I didn't want to leave everybody hanging.
Well, it's interesting. That's the solution for John Wilder in the novel The Secrets of Wilder. When his body starts to, and his inner energy starts to go wacka wacka wacka, that's what brings him back down to earth again.
And there's a lot of people out there that, my understanding, that are doing crown practices, and maybe their feet are kind of off the ground, and maybe they're listening. I don't know. What, would you have any advice to get regrounded?
I was just going to say grounding.
Yeah.
And grounding, there are a lot of ways to get grounded, and we discuss them in the lessons. Some of the basic ones are walk. Go out and walk. If you're feeling too much energy high up, spinal breathing is a great thing to be doing twice a day. That can help bring it down right away in your sitting practices. But get out and walk. Do some physical exercise. Be active physically. Some other things that help is to take a little bit heavier diet for a while. Not permanently, but, you know, if you've been eating a real light, fluffy, you know, very light kind of diet, that can contribute to energies just kind of, you know, flying off in the upward direction. If you just eat a little bit more fatty diet or whatever, just temporarily, just until you get grounded, that can be helpful.
Down to less than a minute, Yogani.
Okay. There are other methods on the website. It's probably better if we just refer you there rather than me try and say it all.
That's right, unless you have that FedEx voice and you can deliver it rapidly. Well, Yogani, your world premiere, it's been wonderful on our end. Hopefully you've enjoyed it on your end. Would you like to come back again?
I'd love to.
Well, that would be a wonderful thing for us for sure. And once again, I'd like to plug the fact that you can go to advancedyogapractices.com and get all these lessons and find out more about Yogani. If you'd like to go to a free yoga class, you can do that at the Cincinnati Yoga School. Any one of the locations, just come in, say you heard it on the radio, and we'll stretch you for free and get you on the road to the other 98%. And don't forget, Virtues First. We need your help desperately. 11130 Kenwood Road, Cincinnati, Ohio, 45242. And you can donate. We'll see you next week here on Yoga, the other 98% on 1360 WSAI, the revolution of talk radio.
Namaste.